started writing, American poet, visiting. I said, God is not blind, man is not kind. Yeah. God is not blind, man is not kind. He is everywhere. Where is God? He is everywhere. Very divine? Everywhere. And then some people ask me, atheist, sir, where is God? Nice. I say, when you are on the campus of which city this place?
Marlboro.
Marlboro? Okay. When you are moving on to Marlboro, you cannot ask where is Marlboro. When you are sitting in the house of Vivek Sinha, you can't ask where is Vivek Sinha. This complete visit is his. The complete visit of the universe is divine. He is the creator. He is the Brahma. He is unknowable. Beyond linguistic expression. Aurobindo said, what after all, forms and names and labels and symbols, what great ultimate spirit. That is divine, that is unknowable, is immanent, is everywhere. Omnipotent, omnipresent, omniscient. You will stand the cell or caves if you get it. God knows everything. That is the concept here. So, physically fit, physiologically fit, psychologically fit. And suppose you don't take medicine in the night. Next time you sit in the class, first bench. And lecture goes on, serious mathematics. What happens? Automatically, what do? They sleep. Shut us down. Even if you keep EK57, sorry, I can't help. Yesterday did not sleep well for 3 days, so I am getting sleep. So physiology disturbed, psychology disturbed, and after the entire bench sleeps. When the entire class sleeps, even the lecturer also sleeps. It happens. So when physically fit, physiologically fit, psychologically fit, sociologically fit, and cosmologically fit, that is fitness mantra. That's why fitness, oneness, openness, happiness, that is the whole concept of mother. So precisely mother is descriptive, Sri Aurobindo is prescriptive. Like a doctor, dawa, likhte, kon, Sri Aurobindo. Usko kon bolte hai, mother bolte. Mother is descriptive, like pharmacy, medical shop. Sri Aurobindo, that's all right, Savitri poet, you take dawa levo, Savitri, or sonnets, or ethical yoga, or Ani himself, or somebody else. That's what your mother says, without me, he exists not. Without him, yes, sorry, without me, no,
he
is unmanifest. Without me, he is unmanifest, and without him, I exist not. That's hidden trail of a soil. Like brother, like sister and mother, master. Brother, that's why you find mother all the time, right side. Even his child, mother's husband came to Pondicherry for some time. But mother, extraordinary genius, I tell you. Because I read much and much and much all these things. I'm happy. I read 35 years. I enjoyed. That way I'm richer than Bill Gates. Right? Or anyone else. Okay, because I'm richer to my students and children. Okay. And she writes, you know, she used to portray the figure of Sri Aurobindo all the time and discussing with the Richard all the time. I want to see gentleman. Figure outline, that line art, the gentleman. And sometimes something happened and it happened for her to see both of them to Pondicherry. She could see Sri Aurobindo, see talent. That's why Aurobindo says, intuition, Ritambara Prajna, in Sanskrit it is called Ritambara Prajna. Intuition is the element of the divine. That's the beginning. Most of the poets are intuitive. Okay? So once again repeat, Pancha Mantra. Five Pancha Mantra, Panchendriyas and Pancha Bhutas. Sri Aurobindo writes on training five senses, which touched me heart, you know. But more modern life, what's going on? Most of people, you know, the five TV channels, eyes and ears, not functioning. Hyderabad nose doesn't function well. Left nostril block. I'll give a hint now, after my lecture, maybe if you are interested, I'll give some therapeutic pranayama. Because sure. There are some senior friends here, some therapeutic pranayama here within the room, within the time constraints. Okay? I'm good at, as I've experienced treating sinus, migraines, also lots of things, you know. I'm good at your kriyas. Okay, right. So this, so Sri Aurobindo again thing is triple mantra, single mantra. That is, surrender, remember, offer. That is single mantra of Sri Aurobindo. Maybe you have Japa Yoga, और हठयोगा मीन्स फिजिकल शारीरिक का लाइक रामदेव महाराज हठयोगी बीके सयंगर ग्रेट वर्ल्ड क्लासिक हठयोगी स्टोनबोर्ड पुणे मोस्ट ऑफ अमेरिकन योग टीचर्स सो कॉल दे टेक द नेम आई वाज ट्रेनड बाय बीके सयंगर पुणे आई कुड रीड इन द नेट यू नो इवन द फिलाडेल्फिया like Sankhya Yoga, Bombay Yoga, and something like Flow Yoga, something, Aerial Yoga, Kurchi Yoga, something yoga, okay, what is there? And, Hatha Yoga means physical, okay? Ha and Ta, Moon and Sun, Solar, Luna, Solar, Energy, Day, Luna, Moon. I say, Solar Foods, Lunar Sleeps, Eternal Sleep, that's most important, okay? Then, so Rajayoga, mind basically, Jnana Yoga, intellect, what Gita tells, three things, Bhakti Yoga, emotion, heart, location, then Jnana Yoga, knowledge, okay, I also call Rajayoga, there are partly different, then Hatha Yoga basically, this physical part, what Gita says, but Sri Aurobindo, in extension of all these things, Sri Aurobindo philosophy is extension of 5-6 domains, is comprehensive integral yoga, intensive and extensive. Comprehensive means including all yogas. Sri Aurobindo writes somewhere, we are not concerned with the noons of the past, we are concerned with the dawns of the future. And he says, old yogas are better. Why not we still better in for the community to come? That is Sri Aurobindo's concern. That's why Sri Aurobindo says, all the time, my yoga is not rigid. Mind is flexible, synthetic yoga, integral yoga, accessible yoga, universal yoga, humanistic yoga, not confined to any ascetic things, no. But discipline, he doesn't compromise. That is Sri Aurobindo's philosophy. That's why he had read East and West philosophies before 20s, master of Greek Latin, Indian language, and he translated many books into Bhartruhari, even into Indian language, including Sanskrit, Bengali languages. And what he writes, you know, Sri Aurobindo, yes, if you understand everything of anything, you can understand anything of everything. Like Andam Pindam Brahmanam, Indian philosophy, Andam Pindam Brahmanam, that's all. If you understand everything of anything, you can understand anything of everything. That's why Aurobindo says, all for each, each for all, by all, for all, of all, that is integral, Sri Aurobindo concept. We were joking with a senior friends here in our mind means sir said, my end is mine. Aurobindo fundamental philosophy is mind beyond. Mind beyond is divine, that's all. What is the mind? Materialistic mechanical mind, that is Aurobindo asked. How many types of minds are there? 7 types of minds are there. Lower mind, the physical, temporal, terrestrial, mechanical, survival, troublesome mind, basic starting. Lower mind, higher mind, intuitive mind, illumined mind, over mind, super mind, supreme mind. That's the mind. Conscious levels, unconscious, jadam, inert. Inconscious, unconscious, injured part. Unconscious, inconscious, self-conscious, external, subconscious, internal, superconscious, the cosmic force. Mind in terms of conscious levels, nothing to worry. Just to experience. So, unconscious, fundamentally. Then, subconscious, mother says, man is subconsciously potential. Man is originally subconscious, but we have got the survival needs. Go cross out of them. Our mother says, it is on the earth alone you can perfect yourself, you can master yourself, you can enjoy yourself, you can divinize yourself, this bit of the Sri Aurobindo philosophy. That is mother concern. As a mother says, it is the inside which governs outside. What a wonderful picture. When you are genetically united, we are universally found everywhere. That is genetically. Though we are physically far and farer, but we are genetically nearer and nearer. So I am with you and you are with me. That is genetical truth, DNA factor, DNA truth. That is truth consciousness. But even genes can also be mutated out of sadhana. Aurobindo says, do sadhana. Open to the divine. He is there. Nothing can be done without the grace of the divine. Divine grace ultimate. They are noble. They are indescribable. And he says elsewhere, remember mother, the divine mother everywhere. Our universal mother, I think that she will be with you, for you, but she will be guiding you without notice to you. That secret he mentions elsewhere. She is everywhere there, but she is not apparent to you, not visible to you. So she will guide you unnoticed by you. That is the Aurobindo philosophy. Okay? So these are the things what Aurobindo wants to say. Again, triple mantra. The triple transformation. Physical transformation, energizing techniques, purification, unification, sublimation. The divine platform, body. Okay? Aurobindo used to do pranayama daily, 4.5 hours a day. Imagine. Even before one year Alipur jail 1910, and after Alipur jail also in a bomb case he was arrested and put in jail for 1 year, vigorous imprisonment. Before that he was strong and militant, was arrested. Then he himself says, on himself writes, I was arrested so and so, but the Vasudeva, Sri Krishna appeared before me and he has given me his mission to me, so I have to address my divine call. He writes elsewhere, the earth answers cosmic calls by the order of divine. The earth answers cosmic calls by the order of the divine. I have to do 3 madnesses in my life. First thing is, again he wants to see the divine at any cost. Number 1, he says madnesses. Number 2, he says, I have got some property with me. Divine by the mother, divine by the divine, must be returned to the society. Honestly, I don't need this much. Second. Third one, he wants to free India, but he says, not alone free India, physically, materialistically, I want to see spiritual India, and I want to do tapas, tapa, the ethical yoga, to do for the freedom of the entire world, to divinize the earth, that is supramental manifestation. Supramental manifestation is nothing but the truth consciousness. Truth consciousness is nothing but again supermind. Supermind is nothing but again mind beyond in philosophy. Open complete to the rest of the divine to take our action further. That is simply supramental manifestation on earth. He says, Indian rishis, monks and sages have done a lot of service, but they have tried to divinize themselves, they try to liberate themselves. Mukti, moksha, liberation. But nobody has tried to divinize the entire earth. That homework is given to me. That's why it says, the entire world religions. He listed all the Taoism, Shintoism, Confucianism, Jainism, Buddhism, all the philosophies, all the religions. All the world religions try to divinize the earth. Aurobindo says, no religion has yet succeeded divinizing the earth. That is through supramentalization. That is the mission given to me. And the vision is supramentalization. And he says, that is the new race yet to come, it comes. And he makes a statement, my philosophy not for the human being on earth. On earth, that means earthly man. People take wrong meaning. No. My mission not for the man on earth, means living on earth only by earth, for earth. No. Earthly, terrestrial, materialistic man, but for the spiritual man. That's good. Let it take 100 years. Aurobindo writes in one of the sonnets, I have 100 lives to steal further. 100 lives to 1,000 years. No problem, 1,000 years also there. Okay. And his philosophy comes into being maybe after 1,000 years. No problem. So this is philosophy.